Good morning and welcome to morning prayer this Thursday morning. We are reading from the Book of Common Prayer, and my name is Leela Quinlan, one of the deacons at Christ Episcopal Church, and I'm honored that you have joined me this morning. There is a light breeze out here today, so you may hear some chimes or some wind rustling, which is beautiful. So on page 80 of the Book of Common Prayer, we're going to begin, and you can also find the Book of Common Prayer online, or you can call the church, and we're happy to leave one at the desk for you with your name on it, or drop it by your house even. The Book of Common Prayer is a treasure trove. So in it we find the services, the liturgy of the services of the church that we do, and we find morning and evening prayer and noonday prayer, compline at the end of the day. Just wonderful resource. You'll find many, many prayers in here. The whole book of the Psalms is in here. And our confession of faith is in here. So there is just everything that you could hope to find. And then you'll need your Bible as well, because we'll be reading a lesson from Matthew today. Page 80 of the Book of Common Prayer. Lord, open our lips, and our mouth shall proclaim your praise. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. The earth is the Lord's, for he made it. Come, let us adore him. And on page 82, in the middle of the page, Psalm 95, 1 through 7. Come, let us sing to the Lord. Let us shout for joy to the rock of our salvation. Let us come before his presence with thanksgiving and raise a loud shout to him with psalms. For the Lord is a great God and a great King above all gods. In his hand are the caverns of the earth, and the heights of the hills are his also. The sea is his, for he made it, and his hands have molded the dry land. Come, let us bow down and bend the knee and kneel before the Lord our Maker. For he is our God, and we are the people of his pasture and the sheep of his hand. Oh, that today you would hearken to his voice. And now we'll move to the psalm appointed for today, and that is Psalm 105. And we'll be reading the first part of Psalm 105, which is verse 1 through 22, and that can be found in your Book of Common Prayer on page 738, or in the middle of your Bible in the Book of the Psalms. Psalm 105. Give thanks to the Lord and call upon his name. Make known his deeds among the peoples. Sing to him, sing praises to him, and speak of all his marvelous works. Glory in his holy name. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice. Search for the Lord and for his strength. Continually seek his face. Remember the marvels he has done, his wonders and the judgments of his mouth. O offspring of Abraham, his servant, O children of Jacob, his chosen. He is the Lord our God. His judgments prevail in all the world. He has always been mindful of his covenant, promise he made for 1,000 generations, the covenant he made with Abraham and the oath he swore to Isaac, which he established as a statute for Jacob, an everlasting covenant for Israel, saying, to you will I give the land of Canaan to be your allotted inheritance. When they were few in number, of little account, and sojourners in the land, wandering from nation to nation and from one kingdom to another, he let no one oppress them and rebuked kings for their sake, saying, do not touch my anointed, and do my prophets no harm. Then he called for a famine in the land and destroyed the supply of bread. He sent a man before them, Joseph, who was sold as a slave. They bruised his feet in fetters, his neck they put into an iron collar. Until his prediction came to pass, the word of the Lord tested him. The king sent for him, and released him. The ruler of the people set him free. He set him as a master over his household, as a ruler over all his possessions, to instruct his princes according to his will, and to teach his elders wisdom. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and will be forever. Amen. And now we'll move to the lesson for today, which is in Matthew. Let me get that Bible here ready. And we're reading from Matthew 7 today. Matthew 7, 22 through 29. Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, the first of the Synoptic Gospels. So 7:22 says this: On that day, many will say to me, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, and cast out demons in your name, and do many deeds of power in your name? Then I will declare to them, I never knew you. Go away from me, you evildoers. Everyone then who hears these words of mine and acts on them will be like a wise man who built his house on the rock. The rain fell, the floods came, and the winds blew and beat on the house. But it did not fall, because it had been founded on rock. And everyone who hears these words of mine and does not act on them will be like the foolish man who built his house on the sand. Then the rain fell, and the floods came, and the winds blew and beat against the house, and it fell, and great was its fall. Now when Jesus had finished saying these things, the crowds were astounded at his teaching, for he taught them as one having authority, and not as their scribes. The word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. The wise man built his house upon the rock, and the foolish man upon the sand. Let us pray, friends, that each and every day we are building on the rock of our salvation. And now we're going to move to page 96 for the Apostles' Creed. Page 96. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now we'll move to page 97. The Lord be with you. Let us pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And on page 98, Suffrage B. Save your people, Lord, and bless your inheritance. Govern and uphold them now and always. Day by day, we bless you. We praise your name forever. Lord, keep us all from all sin today. Have mercy on us, Lord. Have mercy. Lord, show us your love and mercy, for we put our trust in you. In you, Lord, is our hope, and we shall never hope in vain. And now we will read the Collect for Peace today on page 99. O God, the author of peace and lover of concord, to know you is eternal life and to serve you is perfect freedom. Defend us, your humble servants, in all assaults of our enemies, that we, surely trusting in your defense, may not fear the power of any adversaries through the might of Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. and a collect for mission on the bottom of page 100. O God, you have made of one blood all the peoples of the earth and sent your blessed Son to preach peace to those who are far off and to those who are near. Grant that people everywhere may seek after you and find you. Bring the nations into your fold. Pour out your Spirit upon all flesh and hasten the coming of your kingdom. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. And now we'll move to page 101 and we will share any thanksgivings we have to lift up to the Lord or any petitions that we may have. Let us pray. Amen. And now the general thanksgiving, one on page 101. Almighty God, Father of all mercies, we, your unworthy servants, give you humble thanks for all your goodness and loving kindness to us and to all whom you have made. We bless you for our creation, preservation, and all the blessings of this life, but above all for your immeasurable love in the redemption of the world by our Lord Jesus Christ. For the means of grace and for the hope of glory. And we pray, give us such an awareness of your mercies that with truly thankful hearts we may show forth your praise, not only with our lips, but in our lives, by giving up ourselves to your service and by walking before you in holiness and righteousness all our days. Through Jesus Christ our Lord, to whom with you and the Holy Spirit be honor and glory throughout all ages. Amen. And now at the top of page 102, the prayer of our early saint of the church, Saint Chrysostom. Almighty God, you have given us grace at this time with one accord to make our common supplication to you. And you have promised through your well-beloved Son that when two or three are gathered together in his name, you will be in the midst of them. Fulfill now, O Lord, our desires and petitions as may be best for us, granting us in this world knowledge of your truth, and in the age to come, life everlasting. Amen. Let us bless the Lord. Thanks be to God. And now glory to God, whose power working in us can do infinitely more than we can ever ask or imagine. Glory to him from generation to generation in the church and in Christ Jesus forever and ever. Amen. And now, friends, I pray that you will go out and that I will go out and that we'll do the good work that God has given us to do. I pray that we will have courage to step into those tasks that might be challenging for us, and that we would have a deeper and deeper trust of the Lord and what he is doing amongst us. May God bless you this day and all that you do. Have a great one.